All right, so good morning. Welcome to today's team building event. Today, we're going to be learning what to do in the event of an active shooter. We're going to bring in a special guest. She's actually an expert on this, and she's going to be leading our team building event.
Oh, my.
This is Kaylee.
If there was an active shooter, you'd all be dead. When you talk out loud, the shooter can tell where you are and where you're hiding. Sometimes we play the game who can stay quietest the longest, so we all remember. You can try and protect your friends by pushing the tables and chairs against the doors. You also have to put a piece of paper over the door window so they can't see in. And you can't cry. It gives away your position and your hiding spot. And if you're in the bathrooms, you have to stand on the toilet seat and crunch down so they can't see your feet and they can't see your head, so they don't know that you're in there.
That's crazy.
Try to listen for things that could help the police. For example, if you hear a lot of bangs like bang, 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 the shooter might be down the hall. Or if you hear louder ones like bang, 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 he could be right outside your door. If the shooter comes in the room, screaming won't do anything. You have to try and fight back. If you can't escape, we get taught the emergency window escape plan, where you have to break a window, put clothes over the frame, and climb through. Our teacher used to sing a song to make it easy to remember. Lockdown, lockdown, let's all hide. Lock the doors and stay inside. Crouch on down, don't make a sound, and don't cry or you'll be found.